meet the starting five for your Indiana Pacers. At 4, 6'10", number 25, Jalen Smith. At forward, 6'5", number 3, Chris Duarte. At guard, 6'4", number 24, Buddy Hield. In the middle, 6'11", number 33, Miles Turner. Back guard, 6'5", Tyrese Haliburton.
Welcome, everyone, to 2K Sports presentation of the NBA this Saturday afternoon. This is Brian Anderson with Clark Kellogg and Grant Hill. And giving us the rundown from the sidelines, reporter Allie LaForce. Hey, Allie.
Well, guys, Miles Turner is one of the game's premier rim protectors. He said, quote, "I change games. I'm able to push my team, and they know that when I'm back there, it makes it easier for everybody. I want to show the league what everybody in Indy has known for years, that I'm a defensive anchor, and I take pride in that."
Well, he is a presence, Allie, no question. Thank you. And a look now at the Detroit Pistons' upcoming schedule. On Tuesday, they'll take on Kristaps Porzingis and the Washington Wizards. Then on Wednesday, they'll be playing against Clint Capela and the Atlanta Hawks. A look at the starting group for the Pistons. It's Cunningham and Ivy at the 1 and the 2. Bojan Bogdanovic out there with Isaiah Stewart. And it's Bay in at the 3, the small forward. And for the Pacers, they've got Jalen Smith. Tyrese Haliburton is out there with Buddy Hield. Then it's Chris Duarte. And it's Turner in at the 5, roaming the paint. Well, Clark, I think I speak for all of the NBA family in saying that we are eager to get this season underway.
Always, B.A. You know, we love the fact that each new season brings a clean slate for everybody. Players, coaches, announcers, fans. It doesn't matter what you did last season. Everybody starts at ground zero this season.
And the basket by Hield.
Haliburton, all about getting his teammates open looks, does such a great job with his unselfishness making the pass.
Pass to Cunningham. Count it. One for one to start the game.
Just making it look good. The finger roll, such a classy move.
Cunningham against Haliburton. Hield from outside. And again, it's Indiana with a 3.
Long-range shots like that, almost effortless for Hield. Every chance he gets, he'll take that shot.
Cunningham outside. Pass to Bogdanovic. The three-pointer off the mark. Indiana's gone 2 of 2 at the perimeter. Hield with the ball. Haliburton outside. Let's go with a 3. And it's Hield missing. Well, Grant, Ivy gets a lot of attention for his scoring, but he can also lock you down at the other end.
Oh, yes, he can, B.A. He's big, active, and athletic, too. A strong on-ball defender as well. He'll also jump passing lanes, causing deflections. He looks to flip turnovers into points.
Pass to Smith. And the first quarter of action, 2 minutes in. Haliburton finds Smith. Clock at 6. Howard down after the assist led him to the lane.
More than just a score. Hield moves the ball well, especially when his guys are open.
Here's Cunningham, defended by Haliburton. Stewart, a screen on Haliburton. Here's Cunningham.
Oh, and Turner with a block.
Halliburton outside. Pass to Heel. This one for three. The rebound by Stewart. The Pistons trailing. Here's Cunningham. And it goes as the official calls the foul. Count it, and he'll shoot one more at the line.
Well, the number one overall pick in 2021, Cade Cunningham, ended up third in the Rookie of the Year voting, but nevertheless had an outstanding first season.
Misses, and Cunningham asked to carry a developing Pistons team. Something you'd know about, Grant. Any advice?
Just keep working hard, young man. He is on the right track for sure, B.A. I know he will get it done. He loves the game, and he has embraced the challenge of making this team a winner.
And the basket by Heald.
Yeah, no hesitation from the veteran Heald. A dangerous scorer in these catch-and-shoot situations.
Bay outside, Cunningham outside. And he finishes. That makes him 4 out of 5. And first quarter, we're about 3.5 minutes in. Halliburton against Cunningham. Back to Halliburton from outside the arc. He's off on that one. Now the Pistons take it the other way. Cunningham outside. Halliburton with some nice D. The Pacers have gone 4 of 7, shooting a solid percentage. Pass to Heel. Here's the three. The rebound by Stewart. The Pistons shooting right around 57%. Very efficient so far in the first. Outside Bogdanovich. Here's Ivy. Bay outside. The three ball. And he buries his first look.
Slow defensive rotation causing a breakdown along the perimeter.
Indiana's gone 3 of 7 from beyond the arc in the first. Pass to Turner. Drives in. And it's in there. Heald's got 11 points.
And look at the balance from Buddy Heald. Not everyone can stay composed through contact.
Here's Ivy, guarded by Heald. From 20 feet. Misses off the right iron.
Can't blame him. Just trying to take what the defense allows.
2 minutes remaining in the first. 2 minutes.
Halliburton outside. Dorte on the wing. Down it goes, and a great assist by Halliburton.
That's been typical of their performance today. They're sharing the ball and creating good shots.
Really a prime example of the difference in how these teams have operated offensively. Much more individual play at the other end.
And the Pistons call time here. A new lineup here for Indiana.
And they were top 15 in the NBA in second chance scoring. It wasn't a weak point for them, but it also wasn't one of their strengths either.
And their top 10 ranking in points off turnovers jumps out at me. You love to see a team that's so quick to the strike after a great defensive play. They fed off their defense. Now here's McConnell. Tipped. And another shot to the left wing. There's Nesmith with a three. Rebounded by the Pistons. Here's Knox. Pass delivers. Lets it go from deep. And they recover it. Here's Knox. Goal from deep. The offensive rebound.
Oh, nothing soft about that.
Was not going to be denied. Just took the dunk that was right in front of him.
Well, you know, if nobody's going to put a body on him, then that's going to be the result.
Hayes against McConnell to the paint. Here's Bataze. Duren with the rebound.
He's as surprised as we are. Most nights, that bucket is automatic.
To the middle. And the foul is called. He missed it, so he's got a couple of free throws coming his way.
Look, for the Pacers, I'm part of that franchise's history, so I understand the reality of being a small market team. Likely they don't sign a KD or LeBron in free agency. They've had to build through the draft and make good trades, and I don't have any doubts that they'll be able to do that because they've got some good young pieces and are looking good for the future.
No good on the free throw. He does not get the second one. Indiana leading. 8 second difference between the shot clock and game clock. Here's Nesmith. Well, he hasn't put up any points yet in this one. Pass to Mathurin. Back to McConnell. The three is up. Duren with the rebound. Duren's got 4 rebounds now. Down low. Diallo passes to Hayes. Shoots over McConnell. And again, the Pistons missing. Buddy Hield has been leading the charge for the Pacers. 11 points in the quarter. He's on fire. We'll be back in a moment.
Pistons 13.
It's been a pretty even game through the first quarter. All right, a look at how the points have been generated so far. A scoring breakdown for Indiana.
You know, so far in this one, these guys have been knocking it down from distance. You've got to like their confidence as this game continues. They're on a nice roll.
And I just love playing on teams like this, passing teams. You can tell they really like playing with each other, and hopefully they keep this up.
They've got Halliburton, Miles Turner out there with Daniel Tice. Then it's Buddy Hield. That's the 5 for the Pacers. Picked by Stewart. Here's Ivy. Pass to Stewart. Good setup. Led him to the rack perfectly for the layup.
Ivy.
Stewart's got his first points of the night.
When they get their opportunity to punch it inside, they don't hesitate.
Halliburton outside. Beyond the arc. No good that time. The Pistons go the other way with it. After this game, they can look forward to Washington, where they'll match up against the Wizards. That game will conclude the 3-game road trip they're currently on. And let's swing it over to the sideline and hear from Allie.
Well, guys, the Pistons focusing on improving their scoring. Coach Dwayne Casey said, quote, "This is an offensive league. In today's game, you've got to be able to shoot the three because you can't make enough twos to win. It's tough to defend the three, so you've got to keep that scoreboard moving." Back to you.
Floor spacing at a premium, Allie. Thank you. Grant, it's a shooter's league, and we're seeing more and more big men float out to the perimeter and knocking them down.
Well, B.A., the game has evolved, and the shooting, particularly from the bigs, is fantastic.
But, you know, I wish the bigs had a little bit more diversity. I don't mind shooting from the perimeter, but every once in a while, go mix it up and take advantage of your size mismatch in the paint.
A minute and a half gone in the second quarter. Pass to Duren. Here's Joseph. And we're going to have a jump ball.
It'll be a jump ball.
And the fans love seeing incredible moments on defense like that block.
Yeah, what a play. I mean, that'll have the offense thinking twice about taking shots in his presence.
And here's Ivy from the arc. After missing his first attempt, now 1-for-2.
Not a bunch of energy from the defense, which is why he was free to knock that down.
Halliburton, the pass to Heald.
And he throws it down with one hand. Capable of lighting it up any given night, Heald's offensive game is only getting better.
Pass to Bay. To the inside. Here's Duren. The basket drops, and he gets fouled on the shot. One free throw coming his way.
Time and time again, they're creating good looks from close range.
And even under pressure in close, I think they've still done a good job maintaining concentration and converting the opportunities.
Kate Cunningham's checked in for Joseph.
With this Pistons squad, that all eyes are on the future as opposed to the here and now. Young guys focused on reaching their potential.
Smith with a screen on Cunningham. Here's Halliburton. Gets himself open and drills it.
Halliburton's quickness and agility really makes him hard to deal with, especially when he's in close like that.
Cunningham, a screen on Heald. To the left side wing. Three-pointer, Stewart. Pistons keep it alive. Pass to Bay. There's a screen. The shot's good. On the assist by Cunningham.
3 points.
Bay's got six.
It all started with the pass. That's what coaches love to see, ball movement.
So where do you see the ceiling for this younger Pistons team as they continue to grow?
You know, Bia, it's always difficult to predict the limits of a team. But as long as they continue to steadily develop, they can become a unit with playoff potential.
The Pacers were involved in one of the biggest trades of last season, Clark, sending Domantas Sabonis to Sacramento for Tyrese Halliburton.
Tell you what, it gives Indiana one of the most exciting young players in the NBA, B.A., and I think the sky's the limit for this kid, Tyrese Halliburton. He's got all the skill set that you want in the point guard position, and in addition to that, he's a galvanizer. He's a connector. He's a leader. And that could serve the small market Pacers extremely well.
That's good from Heald. And last season, the NBA mourned the passing of Hall of Famer Bob Lanier. He played his first decade with the Pistons.
A sad loss for the NBA. Now, he represented them 7 times as an all-star. But for all his greatness on the court, he'll be remembered just as much for the work he did off the court as the league's global ambassador.
And so he makes both from the line.
Yeah, and for the Pacers, things have gotten stale. So they bring in a new coach in Rick Carlisle, a new potential star in Tyrese Halliburton, a fresh start for this franchise.
Now here's Bogdanovich. Still getting warmed up offensively. No buckets yet in the game from him. Shot clock at 6. Bay with it. Turner covering. Here's Stewart. And finished off by Stewart.
Impressive one-hand slam right there, B.A.
Man, as long as he's confident about it, I'm good with it. Maybe use 2 hands next time. He knows where he is.
Somebody you can count on. He is an extremely reliable finisher.
Here's Halliburton, following the score by Detroit.
He's so dangerous in the pick and roll. Halliburton beating the defense with that pass right there.
Detroit has gotten 3 of their 7 threes to find the net in this matchup. Indiana switching things up recently, going forward in a new direction.
You know, B.A., change can be a good thing. Sometimes organizations can get comfortable winning 42, 44 games, losing in the first round. But the Pacers clearly want more. And you know what? I respect that.
Now here's Heald. 17 points in the game. Ooh, can't tie it up as that one's no good.
Boy, he's got to be disappointed in the result there. I mean, the defender really didn't make any impact at all.
Pass to Stewart. Cunningham outside. Oh, and he got fouled on his way up. He'll head to the line to shoot two.
Second personal foul.
And in Jaden Ivey and Jalen Duren, the Pistons taking arguably the two best athletes in the 22 draft. The youth movement is on, and Detroit is definitely fun to watch.
And he can't get the first one. Some changes for Indiana. Matase's checked in for Turner. Neesmith comes in for Heald. And it's McConnell in for Halliburton. And he's good on the second. After making the playoffs 5 years straight, the Pacers have struggled to get back to the postseason.
You know, B.A., they're trying to go through a rebuild right now, and that's going to take some time. But the front office and coaching staff appear comfortable with this direction, knowing it might be a while before they make the playoffs again.
Inside. Here's Cunningham. It's rebounded by Matase. Indiana's gone 0-for-2 from outside in the second quarter. Against Cunningham. Pass to Matase. It's Dorte on the wing. Here's Matase. Just five on the clock. McConnell from outside. Got a hand on it. Here's Knox. He's marked by McConnell. And here's Cunningham.
Picking up his second foul here. Has to be careful because they can pile up quickly.
Brissett's checked in for Indiana. And the Pistons making a change here as well. Hayes is checked in for Cade Cunningham. There's a minute 40 left in the first half of this one. Hayes misses.
One reason this game is so tight is because both teams are hitting the boards with reckless abandon.
The battle to a standstill on the boards has really been something to watch, and the game's not over yet. We'll see if one of these teams maintains more energy than the other going down the stretch.
And it's the 2K leaderboard. Team leaders in blocks last season. Indiana, fourth.
Now, we all know they didn't allow any easy buckets last season. I mean, their defense was tremendous, and the rim protection was just outstanding.
The first free throw is good. And that one goes in. Two from the line that time. The Pistons have gotten 6 of 10 shots to drop in the second. Nice work. Diallo passes to Hayes. 1:11 left in the first half. Back to Diallo. 6 on the shot clock. The rebound by Neesmith. And stolen by Diallo. Puts up the 8-footer, and it's Hayes with the bucket inside. Hayes has gotten his first points in this one.
And it's energy like that on both ends of the floor that's got them out ahead.
Pass to Matase. He's now 1-for-2 with that bucket. 44 seconds left in the first half. Hayes, the pass to Stewart. Diallo on the wing. What? No scoring yet from him, but that's likely to change. Hayes for three. The rebound by Brissett. For Indiana, they've gone 5 of 10 in the second quarter. 16 seconds left in the first half. Here's Duarte. 6 to shoot. deep three-point range. And a pretty tightly contested game here as we end the first half. The Pistons on top, up by one. All right, now let's check in with Allie LaForce. Allie, what do you have?
Dwayne Casey's here with us now. And, Coach, what was the biggest difference from the start to the end of this first half?
Energy. We had to get energy in our game, pace in our game, cutting with a purpose. And once we started doing that and getting back in transition defense, the game became easier for us.
Hopefully they can find that energy early in the second half. Thanks, Dwayne.
Thank you, Allie. Good stuff. We will be right back after this break for the beginning of the third quarter.
Welcome to the 2K Sports Halftime Show. The Detroit Pistons finding themselves in a closely contested game.
Man, they're getting downhill. They're getting their feet wet in the paint, not settling for those jumpers in uncontested, Jack. They are getting uncontested looks at the rim.
Well, just what Dr. O'Neill ordered. Throw your weight around, move some furniture, make things happen.
Move some furniture? It's going to be some furniture moving in here. Keep talking crazy to me over here.
Kenny, wake up. You're dreaming.
And let's switch gears for a second, checking out social media. Kenny.
Yes.
Lynn Baller's question is directed at you. Hey, Jet, what's LeBron got to do to get back into your top five all-time list?
He is close. He's in it. He's in it now. I think over the year, when he won in the bubble, he jumped to number five in my list. He is five.
So only one answer to that. Beat Kareem Abdul-Jabbar in points.
No, that doesn't do it.
Points. Oh, yes, it does.
No, it doesn't. No, it doesn't.
Yes, it does.
Thanks for joining us. Time to head back over to the third quarter with Brian Anderson.
And after a fairly even first couple of quarters, this second half could turn out to be a great one as both teams trying to gain an edge. Boy, Buddy Hield displaying all his skills today.
Yeah, they've done an amazing job of creating room to operate for him. And then, of course, executing.
And you know what? It helped that they had a few guys with very hot hands on the perimeter, too.
The Pistons leading. And on the floor for Dwayne Casey starting the second half. Ivy is the off guard and Bay the small forward. Bojan Bogdanovic out there with Isaiah Stewart. And it's Cunningham in at the point. Here's Stewart. That falls. Nice feed that time from Cunningham. Stewart's got six.
The defense couldn't collapse quickly enough.
Now Halliburton. Outside heel. To the paint. Here's Turner, and the layup is good off the glass.
Confident in the paint, Turner knows he can cash in from this area.
Halliburton against Cunningham. Outside Bogdanovic. Pass to Stewart. Now Cunningham. Back to Stewart. Oh, stolen by Turner. Now here's Halliburton. A little over a minute gone here in the second half. Now Hield. Smith outside. It's Dorte on the wing. Down to five on the shot clock. Turner, a screen on Bogdanovic. The shot by Dorte, no good.
All alone from mid-range. You've got to think he's kicking himself.
Miles Turner's defensive impact can be enormous. I mean, he is a fierce rim protector, a league shot block leader. You know, teams have to really be mindful of where he is and maybe even shape their offense around avoiding him.
Now here's Halliburton. Down low. Here's Ivy. And we're just about 2 minutes into the final half of play now. Pass to Stewart. Cunningham with the ball. Hield with the defensive effort. And Turner's already led the league in blocks multiple times, Clark.
Yeah, he sure has. And, you know, he's not just all about defense, though, B.A. He's averaged double-digit points every year he's been in the league. And he's a pretty strong finisher at the 10, although I think that's an area that he's got to continue to grow in. And his outside shot has come a long way.
The Pistons have gone just 1 of 3 in the second half. Pass to Cunningham. Well, we're into the third quarter, just over 2.5 minutes played, and he gets it to go. Cunningham's got 11 points.
He's a go-to guy for them because he's that consistent. Time and time again, he delivers.
And we just had to see that mobile one drive one more time. Great stuff.
He made that drive look easy, but that had a high degree of difficulty.
Now here's Halliburton. Here's Duarte. No one near him. That's good. And Halliburton gets the assist. Halliburton's got assist number 7 tonight. The Pistons have gotten 2 of 4 shots to go since the break.
The great read between those two guys. The defense didn't stand a chance, B.A.
These two teammates right here, Grant, they are connected.
And I tell you what, guys, that's a big play to make in a close game. Potential momentum builder there.
It's Duarte on the wing. Right wing. Outside heel. This for the tie! Rebounded by the Pistons. In the third quarter with just over 3.5 minutes off the clock. Cunningham against Halliburton. Cunningham passes to Stewart. The shot no good. Ooh, excellent D there from Turner. Indiana trailing here. They need something good to happen here.
Yeah, they've gone way too long without a score.
Heald, the screen on Cunningham. Left side Heald over Ivy. And he gets it to go, hitting off the back of the rim. Heald's got 19 points.
We all know Heald is a shooter through and through. Love seeing him get room to fire from there.
Detroit calls timeout. And it's a completely new group for the Pistons. He's been patient so far. Nothing yet on the scoreboard. Diallo outside. He tries for 3. Detroit, no good that time either. The Pacers have gotten 3 of 6 shots to fall so far in the third. Pass to McConnell. Here's Mathurin. Over Diallo. And that one's long.
Hard to turn down a look that good. Still, long twos are losing favor, and misses like that are the reason why.
Here's Joseph. It's picked off. McConnell outside.
2 minutes remaining in the third.
For the lead. Rebounded by the Pistons. Durin's got 7 rebounds in the game. Diallo outside. Here's Joseph. He's marked by McConnell. And that one's good. Joseph.
Far from just a jump shooter, Joseph is not shy at getting inside and making it happen there.
1:29 left in the third quarter of the game. Pass to Mathurin. This for the tie! And once again, off the mark by Indiana. The Pistons have gone 4 of 8 in the third. Here's Knox. Here's Joseph. He's marked by McConnell. Livers. And the 3-pointer goes.
Yeah, Joseph adept at finding his open teammates, and that's exactly what you want from your point guard.
Indiana's gone 0 for 2 from outside here in the third. 56 seconds left in the third. McConnell outside. Clock at four. And a foul called on the way up. So he'll take two from the free throw line.
First personal foul.
Man, he made sure to get his money's worth on that foul.
He got him good there. I mean, that's why the shot was so far off.
TJ McConnell. Two shots.
That one's off. And the Pacers making a change here. Brissett's checked in. Hayes is checked in for the Pistons. And the second free throw is good. So it's Detroit now. It's a five-point game. To the inside. Here's Diallo. Pass to Duren. Goes back up. And he gets the bucket. Duren's got nine.
Yeah, another column in the stat sheet that hasn't gone in their favor. To climb back, they've got to put forth more effort.
Now here's McConnell. Shot clock and game clock separated by less than 6 seconds. Shot's good by Matherin.
Good decision making. Scopes the situation, puts the pass right on the mark.
Hayes with it. Four seconds left. And he sinks the layup.
If you allow him to get that close, you deserve to get scored on.
And so it's Detroit with a six-point lead at the close of the quarter. Their key to consistency has been their dominance in the paint. They've been the more physical team. More NBA on 2K Sports right after this. We take a look at our State Farm assist of the game.
You can count on him to deliver a few assists like this one each and every night.
It sure is. I mean, he's a maestro. Great vision, terrific IQ, everything you want in a point guard.
We've reached the fourth quarter in what has been a very competitive game. Should be an exciting finish. Miles Turner out there with O'Shea Brissett. Then it's Buddy Hield. Then it's Halliburton. So that's the group out there for Indiana. Hield against Hayes. Outside for Halliburton. Over to the wing. Clock at six. Pass to Hield. From deep. The long distance three is buried. Heald's got 22.
You watch Hield. Marvel at his jumper. It's as pure as anyone in this league.
Here's Duren. Tries the nine-footer. The shot's good on the assist by Cunningham. Cunningham's got four assists now tonight.
And force feeding the ball inside. I mean, no reason to go away from what's working.
And when you make five in a row in close like that, it also takes pressure off your perimeter guys, too.
Now here's Hield. Nice shot by Turner.
Really adept at rolling after setting the screen. Turner, a difficult cover in these pick and rolls.
Cunningham on the wing. We played just over a minute here in the fourth. Bay outside. And there's the screen. Off target from three-point range. Indiana trailing here. Halliburton outside. Outside heel. To tie it up. And again, it's the Pacers from deep.
This defense just can't stay connected to shooters.
And so it's Detroit with it. Cunningham outside. Trying to go for a lob there. Excellent defense and anticipation to stop it. Outside heel. Back to Halliburton.
inside heel to take the lead. It falls, and now he's 10 of 15 shooting. Nice work.
When you let a team knock down that many threes, you know you're likely to be on the wrong side of a run.
Outside Bogdanovich. Halliburton against Cunningham. Back to Bogdanovich to end the run. Rebounded by Hield. Indiana's gone 3 for 3 from downtown in this fourth quarter. A little over 2.5 minutes have passed here in the fourth. Ooh, he took a hard foul on the shot. So he'll head to the line to shoot a pair.
When you talk about the best shooters in the NBA, Buddy Hield has to be in the conversation.
And a chance for a moment to check out the scoring breakdown for Indiana.
Well, you know, for me, the passing has been fantastic all night. Everybody loves watching this style of basketball where the ball moves and players move. Coaches, fans, and even us broadcasters can appreciate that kind of action.
Yeah, the other thing they're doing is absolutely scorching the net. Red hot from outside all game long.
Stewart, he's checked in for Detroit. Ivy comes in for Hayes. Both good from the line that time.
He's making the most of every trip to the line, providing for his team.
Detroit has gone 0 for 2 from outside here in the fourth quarter. Detroit calls timeout. Boy, Buddy Hield displaying all his skills today.
He can't miss from deep. The defense has to regroup here, and I think they've got to change things up because he's locked in from behind the arc.
Force.
Guys, over that last break, I listened to Dwayne Casey address the team. He said, guys, you don't have to chuck up the first three you see. Keep your heads up. Keep looking for the best option. Let's see how they respond. Back to you guys.
And Allie, thanks. So it's Detroit now, trailing by 5. Around 3 minutes gone here in the fourth. Here's Ivy, guarded by Hield. 5 on the clock. Bogdanovich with a screen on Hield. Ivy's shot is off.
Yeah, they just can't seem to end the drought no matter where they shoot it from.
And, you know, they've got to be careful. This is when the team concept breaks down and the guys start playing hero ball.
Now here's Hield. And Stewart over to help. Smith outside. Launches a 3. The Pistons clear it. Now here's Cunningham. Pass to Ivy. Now here's Bogdanovich. Picked by Bogdanovich. And here's Cunningham outside. The rebound by Turner. Turner's got 5 rebounds in the game. Here's Duarte, defended by Bogdanovich. Halliburton outside. Indiana again missing.
And, you know, even though they're on top, they're winning. I mean, they could use more from him. Trying to shut the door on this one.
Shot to end the cold streak. Deflected. Hield on the wing. Takes the 3. Down it goes. And a great assist by Halliburton. Hield's got 16 in the second half.
And what's working here? Each guy is willing to make the next pass.
And the Pistons call time here.
Get that down. Here are your Indiana Pacers.
So it's Detroit now. 8-point game. The teardrop, and it's Cunningham. Got to get to go.
The floater can be a tricky shot, but that's the right choice.
Indiana on offense. They're on a 16-4 run. Halliburton against Cunningham. Halliburton, the pass to Hield. And again, it's Indiana with a three.
This is what it's been since halftime. Remarkable results from downtown.
Boy, it's been a three-point barrage. They came out gunning. They have not stopped.
And it's Cunningham missing. The Pacers have gotten 6 of 8 shots to fall during this fourth. Halliburton, the pass to Hield. There's a 1:47 left to play in the fourth quarter. A chance to extend the lead to double digits, but it's no good. Detroit has got nothing to fall from outside the arc here in the fourth. 0-for-4. Bogdanović passes to Cunningham. Pass to Ivy. Shot clock at 6. Kicks it out to Cunningham. Tries again. Out of bounds. It'll be Indiana's ball.
Well, I think that pass caught him off guard, but he showed us board hands, too.
Durant, he's checked in for Stewart. They can take their time if they want.
Yes, you have to regroup. Make sure you get a good shot.
Oh, and there's the whistle on the shot. So 2 free throws for him coming up.
A prolific scorer dating back to his college days. Hield just understands how to generate points.
For the Pacers, Buddy Hield. 2 shots.
First one, and that'll push the lead to double digits. And the second free throw, no good. Tough break there. And for the Pistons, they're shooting the rock well at 46%. Bay finds Cunningham. Gets the three ball to go. 55 seconds left in the game. Cunningham's gone 1-for-3 from beyond the arc. Halliburton, the pass to Turner. Pass to Hield. The three. The shot off that time. And it's Detroit the other way.
Things aren't looking good here. I mean, they need points and they need them now.
It doesn't look good, even with a quick bucket here.
And here's Halliburton. 9 seconds separating the shot clock and game clock. Turner, a screen on Bay. Hield passes to Turner. Back to Hield. Shoots over Duren. And it's Hield missing. And here's Detroit. They trail by 7. Bogdanović from long range. Count it! And now they trail by just 4.
And a close game like this, Bogdanović coming up big with that basket.
And now they decide to foul intentionally.
Yeah, just trying to keep this game alive. Not a bad foul right there.
Sure, it's not over. The clock is as much a problem for them as the score is right now, so they've got to try to manage it.
He drops the first one, and that puts him up 5.
You love the seemingly endless energy that Halliburton gives his team. Always pushing himself to deliver his best effort on every play, every day.
So he gets them both. and it's a six-point ball game.
I think it's a wrap. When the game's on the line, he knows how to deliver the crushing blow.
Now a timeout called by Detroit. They're down by six. 9 seconds left in the game.
Showtime. Here are your Pacers versus Jets crew.
Foul on Tyrese Halliburton.
Tyrese.
That's his third foul of the game.
Third personal foul. First team foul.
Nine seconds left in the fourth. Left side Bogdanovich. And so the Pacers take the win. Boy, they didn't make it easy on their fans or themselves. But at the end of the day, everyone on their side is happy.
Yeah, happy indeed. The momentum shifted away from them a few times, especially early on. But give these guys credit for sticking with the game plan and finishing the job.
And that'll do it for this inaugural game of the NBA season. For Allie LaForce, Clark Kellogg, and Grant Hill, this is Brian Anderson thanking you for watching the NBA presented by 2K Sports. And now we present the New Balance Player of the Game, Buddy Hield.